Lord Bateman was a noble lord, a noble lord of a high degree. He could not rest or be contented till he had sailed the old salt sea. Well, he sailed to the east, and he sailed to the west. He sailed all over to the Turkish shore, and there he was caught and put in prison, never to be released anymore. There grew a tree inside this prison, and it was as broad as it was high. And there he was bound and taken prisoner till he was weak and like to die. Now the Turk had an only daughter, and she was fair as she could be, and she stole the key to her father's prison and declared Lord Bateman she'd set free. She took him down to the deepest cellar. She gave him a drink of the strongest wine. She threw her loving arms around him, saying, "Oh, Lord Bateman, if you were mine." They made a vow, they made a promise. For 7 long years they made it to stand. He swore he'd marry no other woman, and she swore she'd marry no other man. Well, 7 long years have come and gone, 7 years and it felt like 29. She's gone and packed up all her clothing and declared Lord Bateman she'd go find. Well, she sailed to the east and she sailed to the west. She sailed all over to the English shore, and there she found Lord Bateman's castle, and she summoned his porter right to the door. "Oh, is this not Lord Bateman's castle? And is his lordship not within?" Oh, yes," cried the proud young porter. "He is just now bringing his new bride in." "Well, tell him to send me a piece of bread, and tell him to send me a drink of wine, and not to forget the Turkish lady who freed him from his close confines." "What's the news? What's the news, my proud young porter? What's the news? What's the news that you bring to me? There stands a lady outside your castle, and she's the fairest one that I ever did see. She bids you send her a piece of bread. She bids you to send her a drink of wine, and not to forget the Turkish lady who freed you from your close confines." Well, now up and spoke that new bride's mother. She never was known to speak so free. Well, what's to become of my only daughter? She has just been made a bride to thee. Oh, I've done no harm to your only daughter, and she is none of the worse for me. She came to me on a horse and saddle, and I'll send her home in coachery. He slammed his fist upon the table. He broke it in pieces, 1, 2, 3. I'll not forsake the Turkish lady. She has sailed the old salt sea for me.